Welcome. Thank you for lending an ear to the Voice of the Times for Friday, April 2, 2021. For today's editorial, DOH should report on the Sinovac vaccinations. There is a current theory or rumor abroad in the land that since the start of the vaccination of our people with the Sinovac CoronaVac vaccine, there has ensued a news blackout on the result of the vaccinations. No light or information has been emitted by our health authorities. It is as if the Sinovac vaccinations have disappeared into a black hole in outer space. A black hole, according to modern science as well as popular lore because of Star Wars and Star Trek, is a region of space-time where gravity is so strong that nothing, no particles or even electromagnetic radiation such as light can escape from it. In much the same fashion, the vaccine rollout in mid-March featuring Sinovac has become a hole or blank wall, which emits no light or information about the vaccination results. The situation is striking because on the one hand, the vaccinations have generally proceeded without incidents or reports about vaccinated persons suffering from the jabs. On the other hand, there have also been a few instances of evident failure. Notable especially are the ones of the top communications officials of the Duterte administration, who were vaccinated and subsequently tested positive for COVID-19. We refer to the cases of Communications Secretary Martin Andanar and Palace spokesman Harry Roque Jr. There may well be others who are similarly afflicted and are unreported. People are asking about the vaccinations because the vaccine rollout began under a cloud of skepticism and uncertainty. There was doubt about the rollout because our government decided to place its trust and faith in the Sinovac vaccines from China when the more impressive and fully tested US vaccines proved difficult to obtain. In addition, the Chinese government sweetened the pot for President Duterte by donating 500,000 doses of Sinovac. This impelled our government to place a substantial order for the Chinese-developed vaccine. In short order, the vaccines arrived from China in mid-March. Our health authorities quickly set in motion their long-prepared vaccination plan, which defined priorities on who would be vaccinated and in what order. Health authorities who man the front lines in the nation's struggle against COVID-19 were given the first priority in getting the vaccine. Cabinet members and other top-ranked officials were next to be vaccinated. The military and police were scheduled to follow, and then the turn of the general public will come, most probably in May. It's now several weeks since the vaccinations started, but up to now, the Department of Health or DOH has disclosed no information about the vaccinations, favorable or otherwise. This blackout of information strikes the public as incomprehensible because DOH, with Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere as spokesman, has been punctilious in reporting daily the latest in the continued testing of our people for the virus SARS-CoV-2. Secretary Vergere has scared people witless with visions about the disease climbing to indescribable heights and about virus variants being more contagious than the original virus. Our people are asking why there is no similar assiduous reporting on the Sinovac vaccinations. Have the vaccinated gotten two doses of Sinovac as planned? Has Sinovac proven to be effective contrary to the earlier fears? What about safety? Have there been no untoward after effects on the vaccinated? Will our country now become the poster boy for Sinovac? These questions need to be answered, and we submit that it is the duty of the DOH as our lead agency on matters of public health to provide a credible and documented report on the Sinovac vaccinations. It should crunch the numbers so the people can understand the issues in the proper light. Only then will follow credence or trust in the Sinovac vaccinations. And that's the editorial for April 2, 2021. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print. Subscribe to its digital edition or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. And listen to the Voice of the Times.